Hello, everyone. I'm Dave, the prayer guy. Thank you so much for taking time out of your busy schedule to watch this video. I greatly appreciate it. I hope that this video and my previous videos are an encouragement to you to use prayer as a fuel for God's mission. My ministry is about teaching about missional prayer, encouraging missional prayer, and engaging in missional prayer. And my hope and my prayer is that more and more Christians, actually all Christians, will really filter and focus their prayers in a missional sense, hoping that God will make new disciples and will grow the current disciples that are around. And one of the things that we need to think about when we're praying missionally, we're engaged in missional activity, proclaiming the gospel, praying for the gospel to go forth, is we need to remember about spiritual warfare. I mean, we live in a world, it's a very physical world. There are things that you can see, touch, hear, smell, and taste. And there's a spiritual aspect to our world that is harder for us to experience, but is there. The Bible speaks about it. And we have on one side of the equation, we got God, the Holy Spirit, Jesus, and all the angels kind of helping us along in advancing God's kingdom. And then there is Satan and the third of the angels that fell with him. And as they became demons and they fight against God, the demons and Satan, they're fighting against God. They're doing whatever they can to stop the advancement of his kingdom, to stop the making of new disciples. And so this battle is raging on in the physical world, and it does make a difference in the physical world. I mean, the three enemies to Christians, we got the flesh, you know, we just have a sinful nature. Unfortunately, it just doesn't go away. We have the world and its systems and how it thinks it should go and how it kind of doesn't do things the way God wants. And then there's the spiritual. Satan, demons, just doing what they can. And so spiritual warfare is a real thing. And so you might be asking yourself, it's a great question, you know, so how do we fight? Well, we pray. We pray against spiritual forces, and we also put on the whole armor of God. And yes, of course, I am talking about Ephesians 6, 10 through 17. I'm going to go ahead and read those verses right now. Finally, be strong in the Lord and in his mighty power. Put on the full armor of God so you can take your stand against the devil's scheme. For our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the powers of this dark world, and against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realms. Therefore, put on the full armor of God, so that when the day of evil comes, you may be able to stand your ground. And after you've done everything, you will stand. Okay, I added some words to this translation, but it's always been awkward to me as I read it. Stand firm then, with the belt of truth buckled around your waist, with the breastplate of righteousness in place, and with your feet fitted with the readiness that comes from the gospel of peace. In addition to all this, take up the shield of faith, with which you can extinguish all the flaming arrows of the evil one. Take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the Word of God. All right, so most of this is our protection. So most of this is about protection, how God is protecting us. He protects us with salvation. He protects us with a shield. He protects us with the gospel, and so forth and so forth. And so, yeah, it's mostly protection, but there is one weapon, and that is the Word of God. The Word of God is a weapon. And we need to remember something. It's not a weapon against humans, okay? So remember, it's not a weapon against human, because our struggle is against spiritual forces, against the dark forces. It is not against flesh. And so when we're using the Word of God with proclaiming the gospel, we got to remember it's a tool for proclaiming the gospel when it comes to other humans, when it comes to other people. But it is a weapon when it comes against the spiritual forces that come against our souls that want to change the world. And so remember how to use that, when to use it as a weapon and when not to use it as a weapon. And so every day, put on this armor. Pray that you would be ready when demons and Satans will come against you, it's going to happen when you're engaged in missional activity. They will come against you and try to stop you from praying missionally. So it's going to happen. So we need to pray that God's going to help us through this. Keep on praying, because we need God to intervene on our behalf. So there's so much more I want to talk about. I mean, there's like three more verses. There's 18, 19, and 20 that I would love to talk about, but I don't want to make these videos too long. So next time I'm going to talk about those. But in the meantime, please like this video, subscribe to the channel. May the Lord be with you, and God bless.